The Cold War began shortly after the end of World War II, pitting Soviet Russia against the United States of America. Fear of communism swept America, coming to be known as the Red Scare. Senator Joseph McCarthy conducted trials between 1950 and 1954 to find communist infiltrators. He ruined many people's lives and careers with no real results, and began an era of fear known as McCarthyism. McCarthy met his own downfall when he accused the army of harboring communist sympathizers. In 1947, President Harry Truman declared a policy of assisting any country facing a communist threat. This interventionist position came to be known as the Truman Doctrine. In 1948, the United States began helping to rebuild war-torn Europe through the Marshall Plan. The Soviet Union refused aid for the countries under its protection. A year later, the North Atlantic Treaty Organization was formed with the U.S. as a member. The Soviet-run Warsaw Pact would follow in 1955. At the end of World War II, Korea was divided along the 38th parallel, with the northern portion communist and the southern half democratic. In 1950, communist northern troops invaded South Korea. Per the Truman Doctrine, the United States sent troops to aid the South. The Incheon invasion under General Douglas MacArthur was successful. The U.S. retook South Korea and pushed ahead into the north. However, Western forces got too close to China at the Yalu River, and Chinese troops pushed the U.S. back below the 38th parallel. Once the U.S. managed to retake all of South Korea for the second time, President Truman wanted peace. General MacArthur wanted to retake the north and spoke out against Truman, so Truman fired MacArthur. A two-year stalemate followed. In 1953, the newly elected Eisenhower signed an armistice that remains in effect to this day. The Korean boundaries remain the same as they had been at the beginning of the war. The only new development was the significant U.S. military buildup. Dwight D. Eisenhower, a World War II general, had been elected in 1953. He placed importance on the delegation of power, but mostly focused on foreign policy. In 1957, the Soviet Union succeeded in launching Sputnik, the first artificial satellite. In response, Eisenhower established NASA. 1961 saw John F. Kennedy take office. At 43, he was the youngest president ever elected. Kennedy's new frontier focused on medical assistance, educational aid, and strengthening the economy through tax cuts. Like his predecessor, current events forced Kennedy to focus mostly on foreign policy. The disastrous Bay of Pigs invasion occurred in 1961. 1,400 Cuban refugees invaded Cuba to try and overthrow the communist Fidel Castro, but failed miserably due to small numbers and a lack of weaponry. Fighting lasted a mere 24 hours. A year later came the 13-day Cuban Missile Crisis. The Soviet Union placed missiles on Cuba, 90 miles from the U.S. coastline. Kennedy instituted a naval blockade and began talks. Nuclear war was averted when the U.S. promised not to invade Cuba, and also, secretly, to remove U.S. missiles from Turkey. John F. Kennedy was assassinated on November 22, 1963. His vice president, Lyndon B. Johnson, assumed office aboard Air Force One. U.S. foreign policy in Asia centered around the domino theory, which held that one small nation falling to the communism would lead to the fall of all the other small nations around it. Like Korea, Vietnam was split into a communist North and a democratic South. The North reportedly sank two American destroyers in the Gulf of Tonkin in 1964. As the North and its leader Ho Chi Minh loomed threateningly over the small South Vietnam, the Tonkin Gulf Resolution was an excuse for war. The U.S. had been supporting South Vietnam ever since the French gave it up as a colonial holding in 1954, and while it initially supported the harsh and extremely unpopular Ngo Dinh Diem, in 1963 he was killed with alleged U.S. support. After the Gulf of Tonkin Resolution in 1964, Johnson escalated troop levels. As early as this, anti-war protests popped up nationwide on college campuses such as Berkeley. They would continue until the end of the war. In January of 1968, North Vietnam launched the Tet Offensive, an all-out invasion of the South. Despite this, Johnson froze troop levels 2 months later in response to domestic protests. President Richard Nixon was elected in 1968. He pursued a war policy of Vietnamization, meaning shifting the burden of fighting to Vietnamese forces and withdrawing American troops. In 1973, Nixon declared a ceasefire in Vietnam, which began the process of pulling out U.S. troops. By 1974, the U.S. had cut off all military aid to South Vietnam. and in 1975 it fell to the communists with the invasion of Saigon. In other news, the United States succeeded in landing a man on the moon on July 20th of 1969. Nixon resigned in 1974 due to his involvement in the Watergate scandal. His associates had broken into the Watergate Hotel to try and wiretap the Democratic Convention, but they were caught, and Nixon assisted in the cover-up.